If you're new to this channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we are going to be getting deeper into our Laravel e-commerce project, and we're going to be handling more advanced topics. One of the things that I really wanted to learn was how to make a project more upscalable without changing too much code. So for example, we're going to be using Stripe as our payment method. Now, if we also wanted to use PayPal or cash or whatever other payment method you might want to use, the way that we're going to implement this is going to allow us to be able to do that in a nice, clean way without interfering with the controller. The first part of it is using service containers. And we've already seen that when we were dealing with the cart, where we extracted all of the core information from the cart, put it into the service container, and then plugged in the service container to the function in the controller. And we were able to clear out a bunch of code. If you're not sure what I'm talking about, I'm leaving a link for the playlist to this entire series in the description and as a pinned comment. So you can go and check it out so that I don't have to repeat myself here. But we are going to be using more service containers. For our purposes today, we are going to be making Stripe into a payment method. So when we do this, you will know how to start implementing it for different payment methods. We will also be using contracts. Contracts will just work like this. We will be using the information from the service container. We will be injecting it into the contract as a gateway, and that's what we'll be calling it. It'll be a payment gateway. And then we'll be able to use that contract in the service provider and bootstrap all of our payment gateways into the app service provider. That will bootstrap it to the entire project. Once we get to that part, I'll show you. I know it's a lot of information, so let's just kind of get into it. Now, to kick things off, we need to go to our services folder, and I'm just going to take this one and I'm going to duplicate it. And then I'm going to call it Stripe Payment Service. Okay, and for now, I'll get rid of this and we'll call it Stripe Service or Stripe Payment Service. And now I'm going to get rid of this, and then I'm going to create a new function, which I'm going to call charge. Now remember, this is only going to be for Stripe. It is the Stripe payment service, and that's what this is for. So now we can go to the checkout controller and head down to where we are using Stripe as our payment method, which is right here. And I'm going to take all of this. I'm going to cut it out of here, and temporarily, I'm just going to put Stripe payment method. Okay, so in the payment service, we're going to go ahead and paste this information in. And as you can see, we have a lot of errors, but the power of service containers, we're going to be injecting things into other things. For example, right now, what are the things that we need? We need the user, we need the request, and the confirmation number, and the cart items. That means that in this charge function, we can go ahead and pass that in. And then the only thing we'll have left to import is this cart down here. And we're going to be using the facade. And that's gotten rid of all of our errors so far. Great. Let's head into the controller and start preparing that to be injected into this. As you can see here, this variable is now grayed out. The confirmation number, the user, and the cart items, they're all grayed out, which means that now here we're going to have to put Stripe payment service, and we're just going to call it payment service. Okay, and let's make sure to import this. There it is right here. So now that we have that Stripe payment service, we can come down to where we made this note, and now we can do that payment service variable. We're going to say charge, because that's the function that we have created. As you can see right up here, it's highlighted all of the information that we're injecting into this payment service. So now we're pulling the information from that Stripe payment service into this controller through the Stripe payment service, which means that now we can just use that variable. And and I forgot something. Cart, oh, confirmation number. So now we have no more errors. So now what's happening is this. Our Stripe payment service is holding all of the variables and information that we need. We're passing it into this charge function from the Stripe payment service. We're injecting the whole payment service into the controller right in the store function, Stripe payment service, and then we are calling the charge function that's in the service, and then we're using those variables from the service to be used in this controller. Let's see if all of this still works, because it should. If we go to the browser, go ahead, refresh it. We'll add an item into the cart. And now we want to check out. Okay, we'll go ahead and use form filler. And then we'll put in the card that works. Pay now. And let's look at the email. Tezzer, I can't do that one. Okay, let's check Stripe and we should have it here. And we do not. So let's see what's up. We go to our console. I'm sorry, if we go to our network and let's say get rid of this, try it again. Okay, we're getting an error. Attempt to read property amount on string. Okay, let me take a quick look. Now, something that you have to understand when we're doing this is that it has to be in the correct order, which means that here we have user request confirmation number items. I'm just going to copy this just to make sure that we have them in the correct order here. And let's try it again. Go ahead and refresh it. Form filler. Okay, and now we have a success equals true. Valio, I cannot do that name. But that is the correct mail address that we have here. Good, so we know that our service container now works. So now that we have our Stripe payment service container working, we're going to go ahead and work on our contracts or our contract. Now, the contract is basically going to take certain information from any of our payment services, and it's going to be a gateway. So whether it's PayPal, Cash, Stripe, whatever kind of payment systems that you're implementing, you're going to be adding, you can always add more on later. This payment gateway will be a contract that will have specific information in it that these payment gateways will need to operate. So let's open up our app. I'm going to create another folder and I'm going to call it contracts. And in it, I'm going to create a file. I'm going to call it payment gateway contract. And we'll make sure and add our PHP. We need a namespace. And it'll just be app contracts. Now we need an interface. This interface will be payment gateway contract. Now this payment gateway contract is very simple. All we need in here is a public function. And this function we're going to call charge. So anything that we use the charge function on will use this information. So it'll be user request and the confirmation number. These are things specific to the payment gateways, which means that now the Stripe payment service, we no longer have to call it a service, we can call it a gateway. Now, this is just a simple naming convention. You can do it however you want. I've seen people do this over and over again in this very specific way, and I think it's really just to kind of keep everything organized. If you call it payment gateway contract, then that means that any payment gateway is part of this contract. So to name your service container as a payment gateway, it links to that payment gateway. It doesn't necessarily links, but it makes sense that this is now part of that contract. Okay, which means that now here we can say Stripe payment gateway. Now, as you can see, if you have a text editor like this, an IDE such as PHP Storm or whatever, you're going to start seeing these errors like this that pop up. So now remember, we were calling the service in this controller, which is why we're getting that warning up here, because it wants to know where that payment service is. So before we get to do that, we need to implement that new contract that we just created. Okay, and it's already been imported up top. Great. And so now this function is yelling at us because the function is not in the controller. So let's go ahead and put that in the controller. So Stripe payment gateway is now going to just be payment gateway contract. Okay, and that should have been imported up top, and it was. Can go ahead and get rid of this one now. Okay, great. So payment gateway contract, our payment service is still the same. So that error is gone. Now we have this as an error. So now remember, we only put the user, the request, can go and check it. The payment gateway contract only has the user, the request, and the confirmation number. So now the cart item will actually be pulling them from the service provider instead of calling it from the controller for our Stripe payment gateway. That means that now we can just go ahead and get rid of this from here. And then in our controller down here, we can get rid of cart items from here. We don't need to put it in. But since we're taking it out from here, we still need cart item information in the Stripe payment gateway. So what I would do is I would go ahead and just do a private function or a private property, and we'll call it cart items. And then we'll make a public construct, and we'll inject that cart items into here. Function. Okay, I'm tired. Okay, so this cart items will now equal cart items. So now this cart items down here won't be cart items anymore. It'll be this cart items. And now all of our errors are gone from here and here. Fantastic. We can go back to the checkout controller and we can grab these cart items from here. As you can see, they're also grayed out because we're not using them anymore. We can just cut them right out of there. And we're going to put these in the app service provider. So right in this boot method here, we're going to take this app and we're going to scope it. We're going to add the payment gateway contract, and we're going to need that class. And we're also going to pass in a function, which is going to be the app. And let's make sure that that's imported up top, and it is. Great. So now in here, we can go ahead and paste in what we just took out from the controller. And let's make sure to import that cart. And then down here, we can just return new. We're going to new up the Stripe payment gateway. We're going to pass in the cart items because it's expecting it. And semicolon. So now Stripe payment gateway is now accepting the cart items. Okay. And we should be good. Let's give this a try and see how it goes. And let's open up our inspect tools in case we get an error. Form filler. Oh, that's the console log we're getting from the view page. Checkout success is true. Let's see. I can't do that one. Let's go ahead, refresh it. And that's been brought into our Stripe. That was a successful purchase. Let's scroll down because I do want to make sure that we have all that information that we put in there, that extra info. Okay, the confirmation number. Great. Fantastic. I know it was a bit complex to get this done, but I want to show you why this would be something good that you can use. For example, now let's say we want to have PayPal. What we would do is we would create another Stripe payment gateway or I'm sorry, we would create a PayPal payment gateway. We would add all of the information that we need for it. Stripe has a statement descriptor, description, metadata, all that sorts of stuff that's just specific to Stripe. PayPal may not use that information, which means that your charge or your payment or whatever it is, however you want to name it, would be different. This information here would be different, but you would just put it in that gateway, which means that in your controller, you wouldn't have to change anything in here. You would already have your payment gateway contract set up. In your app service provider, all of this information would be the exact same. The only thing that you would change is if you had options, you could do something like if request. For example, in your checkout page, you had something like payment form field. So right here on your payment method, instead of having this little Stripe component that you have here, you have a button that says, would you like to use Stripe? Would you like to use PayPal? Okay, so in that instance, whichever one you clicked, you would set it up so that it's sending the request to the backend saying, hey, I want PayPal. Now that request is what will come in through here. And then here you would say if Stripe payment, whatever field that was you had coming in from the front end would be something like Stripe. Then you would take this. You would use it here, and then your else would be return new PayPal payment gateway or cash gateway. And then you would just pass in whatever extra things that you wanted. So let's say you wanted the price to be in USD or in some other payment method. That's how you would set that up. It would be based on whatever request payment form you have coming in. So that's a pretty powerful way to do it. And I genuinely do like this way, and I can't wait to test out more things to do with that. For now, that's good for us. The other thing too is you don't need to use the app service provider to do this. You could create a whole new provider that's strictly just for your payments. I just put it in here because it was a little easier to do and it saved us a bit of a step. But you could also implement that in a whole separate provider and just make sure that the provider is registered in the app. And all of that is in the Laravel documentation. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to leave links in the description, including the playlist, so that you can catch up on all of the videos in this Laravel e-commerce series. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.